Hi. I hope everybody had a good week. It's October 10th, 2021. I had a terrible week. I got in an accident and my face got burned, and I'm dealing with a lot of swelling and pus on my face and a lot of inflammation. Just I'm in so much pain and my face feels like it's on fire. I can't go outside for a while because I have to avoid the sun. And of course, I love to be outdoors and I love to be in nature and in the sun, and I can't do that now. And it's a shame because this summer was so hot and it, couldn't be outside too much because of the mosquitoes and all the sun was like triple digits. So now that the fall is here, I can finally go out, but now I can't because of my accident. But anyway, I don't want to talk about that. So we're going to talk about what, just pray for me and pray that my face heals properly and I don't get scarring. I'm going to show you here some videos about what happened in Lebanon yesterday. The entire country was in a total blackout, and Lebanon has been suffering for decades with this crisis, this electricity crisis. They were initially saying it was going to be about 3 days before they got their power on. The military has supplied the emergency fuel for the military to go to the two main power companies, and so that will be able to give Lebanese people a couple hours, maybe 2 to 3 hours a day of electricity, but only for, I think, a few days. But after that, I think they're supposed to be getting a shipment from Iraq of oil. Iran has already sent oil, and the U.S. and the fake Semites tried to stop them from getting oil. But by the grace of God, he allowed the oil to come through. So they were able to have stem the crisis for a little while at least. And then now, they're just waiting to get more oil. So this is a terrible situation. So please pray for Lebanon. I don't know if any of you guys watched my video last year. I made a video where I talked about a dream of mine, and I had said, when the grid goes down, you'll be set. This was a dream that I had. And also, in another dream I have had, the moon had turned black and was crashing to the earth, like massive asteroid type, not, like a comet type thing. And anyway, I had this dream back in 2020, and next year there's going to be a movie coming out called Moonfall with Halle Berry. Google the trailer. It's incredible. I might, if I remember to do that, I might put that up in another video. Anyway, so here's a couple videos I found. It's very hard to show videos regarding the blackouts, so this is the best videos I was able to find. Keep in mind that a lot of, when the grid goes down, when people lose their power, they can't charge their phones. And so, people, are in crisis. And in the 21st century, we are so dependent on electricity that, just a couple generations ago, they didn't have this problem. But today, with the way that the world is set up, unless you're like living in like, totally as an indigenous person, as in the jungle, and like Aborigine type people, or if you're an Amish person, and even them, they would have problems if the grids were to go down. So I just hope that what happened in Lebanon is not going to happen worldwide. Anyway, so this is a very serious situation, and we just got to keep them in prayers. And to a lot of my Christian subscribers, I want to remind you that Lebanon is about 40% Christian. So those of you who may not like Muslims, you need to understand that the Christians are suffering over there at the hand of U.S. sanctions stemmed by the Israelis who hate the Lebanese government and wants to destroy Lebanon again and create another civil war. So they have just been tested and tried. There's just only a tiny handful of countries on the planet that are suffering this type of affliction. This is just one of their problems. They've got a whole host. So anyway, God bless you all. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
So actually, two of Lebanon's main power stations shut down today, and these are Deir Aman and Zahrani. And the reason, as you've been stating, is the low diesel supply. And more importantly, as a result of the low diesel supply, the drop of energy production from the needed 550 megawatts to 200 megawatts, which is clearly not enough for Electricité du Liban to operate or to conduct all its operations. The darkness is expected to last for around 3 days because Lebanon is actually expected to receive fuel from Iraq as part of a deal between the two countries, and the fuel should arrive today. However, this fuel must undergo an examination process which takes around 3 days, and once the examination process is completed, we will expect an increase in power supply from 0 to 3 hours per day. But for the next 3 days, there is definitely no electricity whatsoever.
And Sally, this is, of course, an additional misery for a population that's long been battling with shortages and with both political and economic crises.
This is very true. And this outage today is something the Lebanese have been clearly fearing, but it is something that they've also been largely expecting because they've been experiencing hands-on the fuel crisis as a result of the economic crisis for several months now, whether this is in terms of the long hours of electricity cuts or long queues at gas stations. However, while it has definitely been exacerbated by the current fuel crisis, the low electricity supply has always been a problem in Lebanon, and this has led over the history for the dependence of the Lebanese on private generators. And clearly this dependence has increased over the past few months, but I believe this is more, or the Lebanese in general see the dependence of the Lebanese on private generators as more of a problem of the actual outage, actually. Because over the past few months, the increase in the cost of access to power from private generators has increased tremendously. And just to put things in numbers, private generators can give households somewhere around 5 ampere of electricity or more. So to get the minimum, which is 5 ampere, a household must pay around 1,500,000 Lebanese pounds, which is almost double the minimum wage in Lebanon, which is 675,000 liras. So this new outage for so many Lebanese means zero electricity, really, because they cannot afford private generators anymore. And aside from the darkness, just to point two other things that could be caused by the complete darkness, we also have a decrease, or we are expecting a decrease in water or access to water, because without electricity, water pumps will not operate properly. And it also means a decrease in access to the internet, because, again, without electricity, internet cannot operate properly, among so many other problems.
Sally Fahad, our correspondent.
Lebanon has plunged into a state of total blackout. Two main power stations are not operational as they have run out of fuel. The Mediterranean country has been struggling to import enough fuel to keep the power plants running. This comes at a time when it is battling one of the worst economic crises in the world since the 1850s. In most places, electricity is barely available for an hour. Officials say there is a complete collapse of network without any possibility of restoring it for the time being. This is the second such power outage since the start of the month. Restoring electricity is one of the many tough challenges facing the government in Lebanon. Several steps are being taken in a desperate attempt to keep the lights on. Lebanon has reached an agreement towards bringing Jordanian electricity and Egyptian gas into the country via Syria. The state is also bringing in some fuel oil for power stations in exchange for medical services. The international community has been demanding a complete overhaul of Lebanon's electricity sector, which has been running in losses. It has cost the government more than $40 billion since the end of the 1975 to 1990 civil war.